Let's say in 5 years, you're walking down a supermarket aisle and you've got two options. One is a conventional piece of chicken that was produced in a factory farm where a hen was selectively bred to grow it several times her natural rate, reached slaughter weight at 5 weeks of age, was fed antibiotics in order to stay alive and to grow at the rate that she has, and that is likely have bacterial contamination. And next to that, an option, clean meat, that was grown from chicken cells that doesn't have the same environmental impacts, does not contain bacterial contamination, hormones, or antibiotics, and potentially has a superior nutritional profile. I think the choice is obvious. So at a high level, clean meat is created by taking animal cells, so from a cow or a chicken or a pig, that could be a sesame seed sized biopsy, it could be the flesh cells from a feather, and putting those cells in a nutrient bath, essentially, which has the same nutrients that would typically go into that animal, but instead going directly to the cells, so not wasting a lot in that process. And the cells grow. And once this process is scaled, what it will most likely look like is a beer brewery, more or less. They're grown in steel tanks, and it's highly likely that in 10 years we'll be able to go down to our local meat brewery and see how our meat is made. By mid-century, we're going to have a global population of 9.7 billion people. Food production is expected to have to increase 70% to meet that demand, and already about a third of the world's land surface and water supply is used for livestock production. So you don't need to be a mathematician to figure out that it's not going to add up. So we need to find new ways to produce the foods that we know and love. And that's why I'm so excited about the food technology space. So the world's first ever clean hamburger was created by a guy named Mark Post in the Netherlands a number of years ago. And since then, there have been a number of players who have popped up in different parts of the world, predominantly in the US. Their estimations for when they're going to be hitting supermarket shelves vary. Most, however, are aiming for probably 2020, 2021. So we could expect, most likely within the next 3 years, we should see product becoming available, and hopefully Australia won't be far behind.